Now, what is a unique approach to healing that mixes together traditional healing and prayer? At just 29, Dr. Kefelezi, also known as INYANGA YODUMO, has managed to make a name for himself and become one of the most well-known traditional healers in the country. He's here to talk to us about his journey. Dr. Kefelezi, Siyakubulela. Hola, good morning, sir. Welcome.
Good morning, Martin.
Yeah, let's talk about how you found out about your calling.
When was it? Actually, I started healing when I was 13 years old. I did my rituals in Zimbabwe. I think it's more than 12 years now, 12 years of healing, because I'm all in this game. So even now, I'm still on it, and I'm practicing it. And I'm also a pastor in MZO church, that's the church mission.
So from the age of 13?
Yes, I did my rituals in Zimbabwe.
How did you find out? How did you know that you need to go to church?
Actually, when you go to church, it's some of the things, they just happen for the sake of it. And you can see that these things are rare, are not normal. And even the dreams, they tell you, even at church, they start prophesizing that, you know, this guy needs to go and take this route. I've been through a lot because of this.
Now, you are, as you say, a pastor in the Zion Church, but you're also a traditional leader. How do you reconcile the two? Because a lot of people say, religion never mixes with, you know, traditional healing. How do you explain and reconcile those two and make sure they work together sometimes?
They do work together, because at church I deal with praying, and then when it comes to my surgery, where the consultation room, it's where I deal with ancestors' things. The bones. I don't take the bones to church. When I'm in my consultation room, I deal with the bones. But when I'm in church, that's where I pray and use water or whatever candles to prophesize to someone. But when you come to my surgery or the consultation room, when I keep on throwing bones down, maybe they will say, no, don't use bones to this one. Just pray. Even if maybe it's over the phone or it's over whatever.
I can do it even over the phone.
Even someone, they just called and say, yes, can you just please prophesize me, doctor? And I'll be like, oh, because I'm an advanced traditional leader, you know, I'm not like those old ones. Even now, I'm still trying to take that level of traditional healing, putting on the other level. I don't want to use that old stylish thing. That is why you even see my dress code. I'm always dressed like this.
Yeah, you're very stylish.
Exactly, I'm very stylish.
Do you think that's what makes you one of the well-known traditional healers today? Because you're what, 29 years old now?
I'm 29 years old.
And you've managed to make a name for yourself. Is it because you're revolutionizing the way and changing the way people view traditional healers?
Yes, the way I work, I take it my own way, and I look at the environment. You know, these days we are in the 21st century, I think. Yeah. So whatever you are doing, there are some people, those who are saying, I don't want to be seen going to a traditional healer. We've got celebrities, we've got politicians. So I have to accommodate all those people in terms like of, if you have someone who is a celebrity who say, you know, I don't want to walk in there, you must have a way on addressing them. How do you address them? How do you help them? Because I'm from Thailand, Paris, Canada. I remember in 2014, I once helped a Canadian family where they had a daughter who was kidnapped. So I had to go there, I helped them. That was my first time to go to Canada. I went there to meet their family. Yes, they found their daughter. I used the muti, and then they found their daughter, even though they didn't believe that this would work. Because these people, those strangers, they kept on phoning them, saying, we want this amount of money. And you know that those, that family, they didn't even give me money. They said, we won't give you money because you're still young. We'll give you a house. This house, it's an investment. So even now, this house, it's still there. People who are renting it.
Wow, that's incredible. How did they find out about you? Because one of the things you also do is that you've got videos that you upload on YouTube, people can see your work across the globe.
Yes.
And I saw that some of your videos, you've got cameras. I mean, you don't show the faces of the people who come to consult with you.
Yes.
But you show your face and you see how you help them. And some of them are shocked at how much you know about their personal life before they even tell you. Tell me about that decision of actually recording some of your consultations with your clients?
Yeah, actually, according to me, I wish I can record all of them.
Mm-hmm.
But as I've said to you, when it comes to privacy, some of the people, they don't want to be seen going to a traditional dinner. But I've got people who are coming sometimes to, for a reality show, because what I do, they are like shocked. So when they come to my surgery, they just video all whatever I'm doing, because some of the things, they are amazing which I'm doing. They've got people, businessmen who comes to me, their business is no longer operating, and they come to me. But the problem is I'm expensive, because I guarantee whatever I do, I'm very, very expensive.
How much do you
charge? Even though I can specify, but it depends on what we are doing. But to consult, it's about 400 rand. Just a consultation.
What's the highest you charge to all? Not just the consultation, but even for the results. When someone consults and they saw the result,
there's a difference.
There's
a difference. You come, you consult, you first pay the consultation fee, right? After that, we need to sort out the issue. Maybe the business, maybe you need to take up your business. I'm always telling people that if you go to a traditional dealer, the traditional dealer say, give me 150,000. Look at that traditional dealer first and see that, is he having that money or not? If you can see that, okay, there is that money, or where is he living? Because some of the things of the people, they take advantage. They charge for the sake of, okay, they see that, oh, this guy is rich, yeah. And then they start charging big money. But I know when it comes to me, whatever I do, it's guaranteed sure.
I saw in one of your videos that you could sometimes charge up to 1 million, right?
2.5 million.
What?
I'm telling you, I know what I give you. That, okay, if I give you this, it will definitely work.
Can you bring back lost lovers?
What
can you not do?
I can't heal HIV and AIDS,
okay.
Asthma, no. Yeah, those things. Asthma, HIV and AIDS. I can, if someone is dead, like, I'm not Jesus, you can say, wake up. No, I can't do that, exactly.
I saw in one of your videos you were advertising, which is another way in which you revolutionize this,
yeah.
Because you were advertising umuthi.
Yes.
Something that men can take. Please explain that to us.
Okay, you know why I've done that? Because most of the time I sit down,
yeah.
And then at the maybe late when after working, I revise, okay,
yeah.
When people, all of my clients came, what are they suffering from? The most thing which are they suffering, I discovered that most of them, they don't get kids or kids. And then secondly, we've got problem, men's, they've got a sexual problem. So I've decided to make something which will help them. That is why I've come up with that. And then that thing, it's trending and it's working. Some of it is used by slave winds.
Yeah,
it makes them like to be hot when they...
very sevens.
Yes.
They come and tell you it's working.
It is working. They buy 4 or 5, but it's expensive.
Is it?
Yeah, the one box is about 400 rand, the other one is about 250 rand.
Wow, okay.
Exactly.
Lastly, where can people get a hold of you? Someone is watching us and saying,